This is Chuck in his new plane. I'm talking. And right down the runway here is a World War II trainer. And Chuck says it's an SNJ. And we're prepping to see Chuck do his first after maintenance flight. Right now he's doing a pre-flight check. Make sure everything's cool. There's Chuck getting ready to fire it up.
My Citabria was a 1984 model 7KCAB, which meant it had a Lycoming IO320 engine rated at 150 horsepower. The 7KCAB was one of four variants manufactured by Champion and later Blanca aircraft known as Citabrias. The 7KCAB has rudimentary inverted oil and fuel systems to allow pilots like me to play at basic inverted maneuvers like slow rolls and Cubanates without fear of temporary fuel starvation problem, which would require in-flight restarts. I earned my IAC stars in this plane. It was economical to operate, at least as planes go, and a joy to fly, especially after I had it fitted with aerodynamic spades, which were a type of servotap to reduce aileron pressure, especially when doing slow rolls. Look closely at my pre-flight sequence and you'll see them hanging down from the aileron cranks under each wing's trailing edge.
Landing. Very nice. Very nice. Oh, it's a touch and go. Oh, it's a touch and stop. Making a nice smooth turnaround and coming right back. That was called a roll by. Hey, it looks like he knows what the hell he's doing, Gene. Oh my goodness, check this out. Thank God I'm not in it. I didn't know just how windy it is here today. Just take a look at this thing. Now you tell me, is it my mind or what does that look like to you? Oh, sorry about that. Sound like a dead engine landing here. Very smooth. There he is, Yarman, Top Gun. Da-da-da. How many kills? What? No thumbs up?
We are rocking and rolling.
No thumbs up? There he comes. The ace pilot of the day. Alright.
It goes a lot better.
Yeah, you like it?
Oh yeah, do you see the roll rate?
Oh yeah. You can buy this tape, you know.
I can?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Don's SNJ-5 is one of many variants of the U.S. Navy's World War II primary flight trainer. It was also produced as the Army Air Force's T-6 Texan and was shipped to the European theater where it was known as the Harvard. Many were sold to third world countries just after World War II. Check out Wikipedia for more info and pictures. We stayed to the west side of the Allentown Terminal Radar Service Area, or TERSA, then headed east at the quarry by the Penn Ridge Airport. We then landed to the west at Van Sant. I have many fond memories of glider flying and flight instruction at this pastoral location in Upper Bucks County, literally hundreds of hours of flight time originating at this airport. During the warmer months, Van Sant hosts a lot of glider or sailplane activity and was home base for the Bucks County Air Force and Wayward Drinkers Association, of which I was a proud member long ago. We race sailplanes informally to practice for more formal contests, such as the operation shown here. In the U.S., gliders are usually towed by conventional airplanes, and once aloft, the pilot releases the tow line at about 2,000 feet above the ground, then searches for updrafts, known as thermal currents, to sustain flight. On a good soaring day, a pilot can stay aloft for hours and may race around a closed course of up to 300 miles at average speeds of 60 to 80 miles an hour. Beauties like this one may have wingspans approaching 30 meters. Joe and I visited briefly at Van Sant with some old pilot buddies of mine, but because the visibility was getting marginal, we headed back to the Flying M Airport before it closed in. A good stable approach and a nice three-point landing definitely rates in my book among the top three gratifications in life.
This is the aftermath. Chuck's playing in the hangar. He wanted me to take a shot of this. I can't do both.